Hello and welcome to Cognos 10 BI training session. In today's training, we are going to go through Cognos 10 BI architecture. What are the various components in Cognos 10 BI and how these components interact with each other? So let's start with the architecture. So this is the Cognos BI architecture diagram. Basically, Cognos BI has a multi-layered architecture and it can be separated into three tiers: web server, application server, and data tier. And these tiers are separated by network firewall. On top of all this tier is the user interface. Now we will see how the web communication takes place in the architecture of Cognos BI. So say a user wants to start a session, Cognos web session, through the Cognos portal, through the one of the web browser, say Internet Explorer or Mozilla Firefox. So the request from the web browser is sent to the web server where the Cognos gateway resides. What is gateway? Gateway is a software program that acts as an intermediate party between web server and other server, in this case is an application server. And its task is to pass the request which it receives from the web browser to the dispatcher, which is there in the tier 2, the application tier. Alright? Then what happens to the request when it comes to the application tier? Basically, application tier consists of dispatcher and content manager. The task of the dispatcher is to operate the services and route the requests. So it receives the request from the web server gateway and sends back the corresponding response. And each dispatcher has a set of services and is responsible for starting all the services. So what kind of services does the dispatcher manages? For example, report services, which runs the report; log services, which records log information generated by various services; and many other information such as batch report services and delivery services, which delivers reports via email. So whatever, whenever a request comes which needs any of the services, the dispatcher manages those services. Okay, along with that, we have something called as a content manager in the application tier. Well, content manager is a Cognos BI service which manages the database, which is known as the content store, and it is present in tier 3. So if there is a request to access the information from content database or content store, which is present in tier 3, then it is done through the content manager, which is present in application tier. So let's see what happens in tier 3, the data tier. As we said, that data tier consists of content store database and any other data sources or reporting databases. So what is the content store database? Content store database means it is a database which contains all Cognos related metadata, such as report specs, packages, models, any report schedule information, any user security information. This all information which is related to Cognos, which is the Cognos information, which is the metadata for these objects, are being stored in content store databases. And this database is completely managed by the content manager. Along with that, in the data layer, there is reporting databases. So these data sources are the relational databases or the data warehouses or any other flat files that can be accessed through the Cognos user interfaces. For example, the data we see in any report comes from these databases, and to connect to these databases, we need to create a data source connection. So this is how the communication takes place in the architecture of the Cognos BI. Let's understand in more detail about this user interfaces. Basically, user interfaces is broadly classified as web-based and Windows-based tools. Web-based tools are those which needs an installation to be done on the client machine. So if you want to work on Framework Manager, you need to have the Framework Manager software installed on your system. So what is Framework Manager? Framework Manager is a tool for creating the metadata out of the data which comes from the database. So this metadata is then presented to Cognos BI server in the form of packages. And these packages can be accessed by the reporting tools in order to create the reports. And what kind of models can be built from Framework Manager? Relational as well as dimensional. When we go through the Framework Manager training, we will go in detail about the relational and dimensional model. We will create a relational project, a relational package, and a dimensional package. So we'll just go through all those things in the Framework Manager training session. And then in Windows-based tool, there's one more tool known as Transformer, and it is used to create power cubes. And in this, the data is presented in form of dimensional hierarchies and levels. So as I say that these are the metadata modeling tools, and metadata is nothing but presenting the data in the way your business is required. So business presentation of the data present in the database. Apart from Windows-based tool, we have web-based tools. So all the web-based tools can be accessed from Cognos connection. All right. So currently two browsers are supported: Internet Explorer and Mozilla are supported by the Cognos for accessing these web-based tools. So what happens in Cognos connection? What is Cognos connection basically? So Cognos connection or Cognos portal is the entry point for accessing the other web tools. And from Cognos connection, we can also access the administration portal. An administration portal is used for managing all kind of admin tasks, such as if any kind of a deployment to be done, or say you want to create a data source connection, or any kind of a configuration, security, report scheduling, all these things can be done from Cognos connection. So the various web-based tools are, which are also known as reporting tools, are Report Studio, Query Studio, Analysis Studio, and Event Studio. So Report Studio is a web-based tool and is used for creating professional, simple, and complex reports. Using Report Studio, we can create report in relational and dimensional style. A Query Studio is a web-based tool used for creating ad hoc reports. And an Analysis Studio is a web-based tool mainly used for multidimensional analysis reporting. Then is the Event Studio. It is also a web-based tool, and it is used to set up an agents to monitor your data and perform tasks when business event or exceptional conditions occurs in your data that must be dealt with. When an event occurs, people are alerted to take the action. So in Event Studio, we have to create an agent which will monitor some task. And if some exceptional condition occurs, then it will trigger some alerts so that the people who needs to know that the event has occurred can take a corresponding action. Now let's see in detail How these components are interacting with each other. So here is the workflow. So basically, Framework Manager pulls the data from the various data sources. It builds the metadata model. It means the Framework Manager modeler will build the metadata model from the Framework Manager and create packages or publish packages to the Cognos connection. These packages are then accessed by the web-based tools for reporting purposes. Okay, so this was it about the Cognos architecture, the components, and how they interact with each other. In our next session, we will learn about what are the various versions of Cognos available in market, which one is the latest one, and what is the difference between all of these versions. We will see about how to create a connection, data source connection in Cognos, from administration as well as from the Framework Manager, and from there we will start with the creating relational model from the Framework Manager. All right, so see you in next session. Thank you so much.